gathering today. I've said this before, and I don't know who watches this, if anybody, but I've been playing Magic the Gathering for freaking ever. I mean, just forever. So, I'm pretty good at it. Yeah. But, let me just dive right in. Now, oh, cool. Rotations and renewal gifts and all sorts of good stuff popping open. Let's look at it. Alright, I'm jumping right into the best one in here. That's going to be this card right here. It's a werewolf. Oh, it's just a wolf. But it has trample. Trample's awesome. When it enters the battlefield, pay 2 any number of times. When you pay this cost 1 or more times, put that many +1/+1 counters on it. Oh, what? It's a 3 cast! And it's already a 4/3! That's ridiculous! Then, up to that many target lands you control. Stop that. You control become. There's still lands! That's really strong. Ooh. I didn't even look at the rest. Look at all this stuff. Oh, this is great. Here, I'll look at all that later when I'm building a deck. When I'm building a deck. Well, I can't do that. You know, sometimes when you go into the store, you can find some free packs. So, see. No, I don't see anything like that. Here, we'll go straight to the packs. Well, I could get a booster, but I only have 3,000, so I think I'm just going to save it and see what comes up. Alright, here, let's go get one from the store. Oh, it wants me to. It's like part of a quest or something. Okay. What? I'm supposed to go to PAX and I'm supposed to buy one. Okay, well, let's buy one. Let's buy a pack. Cool. Oh, no, I gotta go here. I can't wait either. Oh, something charged up over here. We got a few uncommons, a bunch of commons. And the rare card is gone. Oh, cool. So you do quests and you get more boosters. Okay. So like I said, I've played Magic the Gathering since about 1998. Maybe 1997. Somewhere in there. I was just a young boy. And I was terrible at the game. In fact, I didn't know how to play. But my neighbor did. Both of my neighbors. My neighbor on the left, Philly, he played Magic the Gathering, and he was really good. And then my other neighbor on the right, a guy named Brian, and he was good too. But Brian is the one who taught me how to play. I'd never heard of it. I didn't know anything about it until they picked it up. And they knew each other, but they were, you know, more acquaintances than friends, so they knew each other through me. But, anyway, so Brian teaches me how to play the game, but he's teaching me wrong. He was cheating. And then I'm like, I want to learn how to play this so I can beat you. So I went to my parents and I said, I want to play this game. It's called Magic the Gathering. Well, where do you get the cards? At the time, it was kind of hard to find. You couldn't just go to Walmart and buy a pre-deck or anything. And so we had to figure it out. We actually had to drive like 45 minutes to get to the place. Some store with the name Battle in it. I really can't remember. But I get a pack and I go home and he's just stomping my butt left and right. And then one day he comes over and plays with me. And my dad's there. And my dad's been reading the rule book. I never read the rule book because I was like 11 or something like that. And my dad reads a rule book, and then he starts to notice what's going on. And the first time that he tried to make up a rule, to benefit his situation, my dad was like, hey, whoa, wait. According to this, and he went through the whole game, and it got to the point where Brian was like, I don't want to play anymore. He got so mad. Anyway, my dad actually taught me how to play the game. And he doesn't play Magic. That's a pretty cool dad thing to do. So I learned how to play, and I was still not very good. I just never really understood the concept of combos because my focus just wasn't right. But I did learn, ultimately. And I would win games and I would lose games. But then I started getting really good when I picked it back up. Because I'd played, you know, for off and on for like a couple years, 2, 3, 4, something like that. And then I picked it back up when I got a little older and really learned how to play the game and became a judge and played in tournaments and won tournaments. And yeah, it was a lot of fun. It was a good time. A good time was guaranteed for all. So anyway. Oh no, I did it again, didn't I? I forgot to pull up the chat. So let me just do that really fast here. Oh, it looks like I have a viewer too. What do you know? Hold on. Just gonna pull the chat up real quick. Pop up. There it is. Do that. Cool. All right. Oops. I think I made a mistake. There it is. Okay, cool. All right. Now we're good to go. Now we're ready to go. So right now what I'm doing is mostly just trying to beat the campaign. I mean, you know, I got through the tutorial, which I say get through the tutorial. I wiped the tutorial with a napkin and threw it in the toilet and flushed it because it was, you know, the tutorial and I already know how to play. And then I played a few games after that and yeah, I haven't lost to the computer and I don't expect that I will. Maybe I will when it gets really hard. You know, I'm sure they've got some serious challenges in here. But right now, the more of the campaign that I play, the more cards I receive. And then we go into some deck building. And get enough of these done, and I will totally do some deck building. And I love deck building. It's the funnest thing in the world. You know, what I build will be kind of a rough draft version of what I ultimately want to go for. But the more cards you unlock, the more you can develop these decks. And it's a lot of fun. And there's really a balance. And we'll go into all of that. But for now, let's start. I'm just going to hit play. And, okay, so goblins everywhere. Oh, that's what I'm using, is the goblins with everywhere. Which I haven't really used this. Okay, so, oh, I got to find how to get to that campaign. Okay, get out of here. I'm not exactly sure. Shoot. Yeah, I have no idea. If I say one more time. Play more black color challenges. So, where are the challenges? See, I do. I definitely want to unlock the rest, especially black and green. Oh man, white. Like, there's so many great things you can do, especially if you want to do multicolored decks. But I've got to find these challenges. So I apologize. I'm working on it here, guys. Just bear with me. Just bear with me. So, play more black color challenges. Where am I going to find that? would have to be in home. Jumpstart. What is this? Hey. Wait a minute. Here we are. Here we got some challenges. This looks right. Challenge duh. Okay. Let's go. Alright, so. Alright, let's do it. So I guess I'm playing white, which is cool. That's pretty easy to play. White has so many healing properties that it's just ridiculous. Plus, you know, they got some real thumpers that you can put out there to do some damage. Now, I've noticed with these challenges, it's like they're waiting for you to make. Like, it's already predetermined what you're going to get. So if you're like, oh, it's too good to be true, that's because it is. And it's up to me to basically play the best move possible. It's no different than a chess challenge, except it's magic. So we're going to play the planes. That's why I don't get the option for a mulligan, where I can take another turn, play another planes. And what do we got? Whenever I gain a life, I put a plus one counter on it, but he's only a 1-1. There's a 1-1 out with Death Touch. Whenever another creature enters the battlefield under my control, I gain a life. So these need to be played first. And when I play, I get the option to block. I'm not forced to do so, and he can't attack my creatures directly. I'm going to be able to gain life like ridiculous. So I'm just going to keep taking the damage, especially since it's so early in the game. I really don't have much to worry about. We're going to play another one of these guys here. And we'll just auto-play. I'm not worried about the mana. And I've gained a life. I'm not going to attack. Actually, I can attack and I'd be perfectly safe because he doesn't actually have Death Touch. So let's go ahead and do some damage. There we go. Now next turn, I'm going to play Hallowed Priest. And I'm instantly going to gain 2 life from these two creatures. And when I do so, he gets a +1/+1 counter for each one. So I'm going to get 2 of it because I put those out first. It's all about order with this game. You have to basically set everything up for the order that, you know, gives you the most reward here. Like that. Okay, now I can attack with these guys. I won't be able to really play any. I'm not worried about this so much. I really want a creature. Now, it wouldn't be bad to get something flying like my 3-3. Now, I'm just going to be gaining life. This is really good. I'm not going to block. Yeah, this I've pretty much already won. Let's go ahead and give him flying. Like that. And then it's a 6-6. Oh, I see. Yeah. I keep wanting to click and drag where I take it, because I was playing some Hearthstone the other day. Something I don't play too often anymore, and I'm not going to block. I just take the damage. I'm at 14. She's at 8, and this game is basically over. Play it. There we go. Beautiful. And I believe that's game. Easy. Easy challenge. I think it's time to trim. I'm like, yeah. Just go ahead and upgrade the deck. That's what they expect you to do. They want you to use the new cards they're giving you. Now we're going to play against blue. A lot of flying in blue. Counters, boomerangs are the major spells that I would use with blue. Also, blue is really handy for nulling a deck, which means getting rid of their library so that ultimately I have to discard. What? You will need to discard down to 7 at the end of my turn. Oh, I see. Yeah. Need to get him out. He gets first strike. That's cool. If I pay into it. But that's only until the end of turn. Let's go ahead and play him. I'll get the first creature out. It's a 2-2. That's not so bad. That's a handy little deal there. I guess I could do another one. Okay, so it's been my experience that if blue has 3 untapped lands, he's considered very dangerous. I think I'll wait, and if nothing happens, then I'll play this. Nothing happened. Go ahead and put another one out. Ah, my nose is itching so bad. I just realized there's no music. So let's change that. Let's go to OBS. Oh. Okay, there is music, apparently. Sorry, man, I don't know what to say. Sophie Call and Droop Dog. Droop Dog. Droop Dog is always there. I think Droop Dog is a bot. That's what I think. Alright. So he's got a 2-1. It's just a merfolk, but it could kill me. So here's what I'm going to do. This is easy. I'm going to go ahead and go right into combat. And I'm going to attack with both. Next. He's going to block. And then I'm going to play this. Like that. Easy. And I'll be safe not to use the other one. I'll just do the 2 damage this time. Just in case he's got something up his sleeve. I don't want to play all my best cards too soon. Not that this is a best card, but I think you understand what I'm saying there. It's a 4-4 flying. That could be challenging. Oh, I see. Okay. Got it. Yeah, I understand how this is going to work. Blocking or blocked creature. So I'm going to give one of them first strike. And that spell there to kill that and keep my... Yeah, so I'm going to all attack. Like that. Now he has first strike, and I still get my damage in. Board's still clear, so I'm looking okay. Another 4-4 flyer. But look what I got. Oh no. It's okay. I can take care of that. No, I can't. No, I can't take care of that. Because they don't have flying. Double strike. When he attacks other creatures I control, gain double strike. Oh. Whoa. Cool. No attacks this time. End the turn. Another 4-4 flyer. But isn't that Cute. Nothing I can do here. Hey, what's up, man? I'm streaming. You can come on in. Whenever I gain a life. A lot of good that'll do me. I know. I'm still pretty good at it, though.
I thought you'd forget how to play.
No attacks again. I'm gonna end up going down to at least. Ooh. I don't know. It could be bad. What was that? Oh boy. Okay. Now I'm down to 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think I won. Tap all creatures your opponent controls. Everything has double strike whenever he attacks other creatures. Then. Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful news. I just won the game.
Good job.
So that's 3, 7, 9, 18 points of damage I have here. Because of double strike. Ta-da!
Tra-la-la!
Tra-la-la!
I'm Captain Underpants, huh? Alright, I'm gonna go back upstairs.
Hey, will you make me some more coffee? Maybe I should do it. I don't know. Never mind.
I'll make you more if you want.
Yeah, I just don't want you to have to carry it downstairs.
That's a good point.
I'll go up later. Love you, son. Hey, Liam. Yep, he's gone. Couple of double strikes, couple of those guys there. Six, Pacifism won't work, I believe. That's what hexproof is. A player or permanent with hexproof can't be the target of spells or abilities. Enchanted creature can't attack. It doesn't say target. No, but I have to target it onto it. So it's not going to allow that. Actually, I actually have to kill him. Which I can do. So. Like that. All right. Doing good. 10. Play Sarah Angel next. Haven't seen Sarah Angel in a long time. Everybody loves Sarah Angel. It's like a 4/4 flyer or something in Vigilance. Yeah. Oh. I may not want to do that. Hold on a minute. I could. I don't need it. I'd rather have Sarah Angel out first. I mean, before, that would have ended the game, though. Whoops. I made an error. I doubt that anything could be played to really turn the tides here, though, so... yeah. There. I could have ended it last turn, so yeah, I made an error. How's chat doing? How's everybody? Let me know in the comments. How's your weekend going? Have you played Magic before? Have you always been a fan? How long? Fan of the game, not a fan of me. I don't think I have any fans. I'm just saying. Like, how did you learn about Magic the Gathering? Let me know. What's this? It's an old woman. She looks like an old card, maybe. I don't know. Oh, I can choose to mulligan. Life gainer. Pacifism. 3 lands? I think I'll keep that. Okay. Lifelink. Ooh, love lifelink. When he enters the battlefield, put it on each creature. Add 1 mana of any color, add 2 mana of any color, spend this mana only to cast spells from your graveyard? Turn. Whoa. Can't attack or block, but can still use as mana, so that wouldn't help me terribly, would it? Another creature enters the battlefield, I gain a life. Whenever I gain a life. So I'll put this guy out first. And then I'll play this. Good. I'm not gonna attack this time around. I want another one of those cats coming out, though. That would be cool. This could build quite fast. Reach. What is this? Daybound? Nightbound? Oh, it morphs. How does it work? How does it work? I've never heard of Nightbound or Daybound. All right. Let's play. Definitely going to play that. Absolutely going to play that. So I will play. Then you. Like that. At 23. So everything's going according to plan. Good. Now I'm right where I want to be. Unless he plays something crazy. Creatures I control gain lifelink. That could be really handy. Especially if I just played a creature and boost up my guys a little bit more. Ugh. He really doesn't have anything too threatening right now. What's this? Okay. Definitely not able to play that, or that for that matter. So changes in according. Oh, that's so cool. That's a really cool card. What was that? What happened there? Not sure, but okay. I'm at 23, so I'm just gonna take it. Has to block the 6, guaranteed. I think that's going to be game next turn. Just tap everything and then do a massive amount of damage. Yeah, that's what I'll do. Uh-oh. That's okay. I've got my ace in the hole as long as I get... tapped out. Angel of Vitality. If I would gain life. Plus one instead. Felt like it was an actual game, though. Like, did I just play a player? Because at one point, yeah, I don't get it. Because at one point, I saw a selection become made and then taken away. A computer wouldn't do that. Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I just saw it. I don't know. But that was fun. Against another player. Oh! Oh, it was another player. Oh, cool. Well, hey, look at that. I got a PvP match in there. I didn't even realize it. So, here's all the challenges. This is what I'm looking for. I definitely want to unlock Black. I gotta unlock all of them, right? I think that's ultimately the goal here. So, let's do that. I like playing Black. It's actually really hard to play Black, depending on... They do a lot of self-damage and sacrificing your own creatures, but they also do a lot of gravework stuff, or graveyard stuff, which is really cool. So it can be a lot of fun. It really can. Like a 1-1 death touch rat, like, that's great. Like, you get your 5-5 out there, that's okay. Whenever a creature an opponent controls dies, put a +1/+1 counter? Oh my. Target creature gets anyone? Well, definitely gotta get that out there. Okay. This is gonna be pretty easy. I don't have to, but I'm going to. I didn't have to kill the creature, but it was there, so I might as well. Hey guys, I'm going to take a quick break. Really quick, just gonna go make some coffee and come right back down, so I should be like maybe 10 minutes. So hang tight and I will totally be right back.
show got another storyline. Sit yourself down, about to be a gory time. Toss away, we're back on the come up. Wanna step up, get my sum up, we gon' find out. This is destiny to be the greatest guardian alive. Can't be complacent, Crota got it once. Or it's got two, third time. I'll tell you what we gon' do.
Okay, let's get back to her. I'm gonna get back to her. Alright. Knock these out. Oh, I don't know. Oh, I remember this song. I like this song. It comes up all the time, though. But it's good. That's fine. Yep. That's a game. mana flooding. Right in time. I didn't even need to do all that. I don't know what I'm doing. Trigger happy. Oh, well, it's not over, I guess. Flying is... That's cool. You got some damage, Mr. Computer. Where were we? That's where we were.
money and in the end I'm feeling richer than ever. Cause I'm hanging with my homies, meeting cool cats who never would've known me. Keeping on schedule, man, that's half a battle right now. I'm sure I'm late to my own damn panel. I kicked back a Red Bull, now I got wings. Hello, I'm here to talk to you about raps and things. Since you're here, come and kick it with the NBCs. If you chill, we don't care about who you ain't. Let me see your hands if you got that God life.
I lost this one. I couldn't get the damage out there fast enough. The creature's gonna die, but man, I lost this one. Where did I go wrong? I think it's where I put that enchantment. Dang.
Yeah.
And I should have played that a long time ago too, and gotten. That's game. Because everything has flying, and I knew that was gonna be a problem. Well, dang it. So he's got this blocker here, so there's just nothing I can do here. It's over. Oh, add insult to injury here. Just go ahead and play it. I don't know why I would, but... Ouch. Well, dang, I didn't expect that. Oh well. I should have played that enchantment a long time ago to gain life. Keep doing that again. Get out of my car. Pump! Right, I know it is. No attacks. The other one. And another one. We'll attack.
attack.
Okay.
That was the mistake I made. I should have used it right away, and I didn't notice it because I didn't read all my cards. This is the much better way to do this. Yep. That's how you do it. That. And then he's going to do another, I think. Yeah. This is that enchantment. Now then. Still have one left. Needs to go on him. I'm gonna hold on to this. Okay. That's fine. That's what you do. That's where I need it. Okay, this is gonna work out a whole lot better. Okay. It's okay. It served its purpose. Okay. Let's do this. Ah, did that wrong too. That's all right. That's all right. I think I got this one. Yeah, I got this one. Cool. What happened? Oh, crap. Got me again! You kidding me? Oh, to damage. Ah, I thought I lost. I was like, how? How? Alright. What's up, son?
probably even trying to
read
this.
Oh, yeah? He's got the flash. Yeah. Is that Grodd?
Grodd.
I'm sorry. Grodd. It's Grodd. Clearly it's Grodd.
Not Groot.
I didn't say Groot.
Oh.
I said Grodd. Which was still wrong.
Grodd.
Man, that was tough. That was a tough one. So this next one is going to be a PvP match. And I've been down here for the better part of an hour, so I should probably go back upstairs and get back to being a dad.
Don't go upstairs.
Why?
It smells like that Sharpie because Ava... No, the picture.
It smells like a Sharpie?
No, because the picture I threw away, Ava took out of the trash and now is keeping it again.
No.
Missy doesn't want me to throw away.
Oh, for goodness sake.
That's why I came down here.
Hey. Oh my goodness gracious. Chimney Christmas. Don't go upstairs, he says. Like, don't do it, Dad.
You'll die.
Don't do it, you'll die.
I have a collectible. Three. I actually have three. I also have another Flash comic, but I don't think that's like these type. I don't think they're like old Flash comics. And do you know if Aquaman's actually in the Flash? Because I have a comic that says Flash versus Aquaman, and it's like a race.
Hold on a minute, okay? Guys, I'm going to jump off later if there is anybody out there. If you are out there, you liked what you saw, a little bit of Magic Gathering. I'm going to start doing PvP after I get into deck building. But, you know, just basically unlocking cards and playing the game. And anyway, hit the follow button, the like button, whatever the buttons. There's plenty of buttons. Be sure to come back, subscribe, and all that crap. Later. Have a good one. Peace.
Hit the bell.
I think I get a...